I've got a very quick and easy Premiere Pro tutorial for you. We're going to create the following freeze frame sequence effect. There are a couple of prerequisites for this effect. First of all, you need a shot that was taken on a tripod, or by someone with very steady hands. If you don't use a tripod, then you can get strange artifacts like this. And a clip with a high frame rate gives the best results. 60 or 120 frames a second would be recommended. A higher frame rate is better because this will give less motion blur. It is also recommended to have the subject on the foreground with more darker colors versus a lighter background. And last, the subject in the shot should be moving across the frame, from left to right for example. Okay, let's stop wasting time and move over to Premiere to start editing. Inside Premiere, I've got this clip on the timeline. It's a clip from a woman running on the beach from the left to the right. The few steps for this effect are very easy. First, we need to duplicate the video layer. We can do this by holding the Alt key combined with the left mouse button and then drag it up one track above. In this case, we want three extra layers on top of the original. So I will make three copies like this. And then we need to scrub through the timeline to find the point for the first freeze frame. I think this is a good frame. Then we need to right click on the first copied track, the second layer, and then select Add Frame Hold. This will cut the track in two parts. We don't need the first part, so we can delete that. The second part that we kept only contains the single frame that we just selected. Now let's continue on with the other tracks and do the exact same steps. I think this is a good frame for the second layer. Select the layer, right click, and then select Add Frame Hold, and then delete the first part. And also the same steps for the last track. Right click, add frame hold, and then delete the first part. If we playback, Premiere will always display the track on top or highest in stack. So now we will only see the frozen frames, and that's why we need to blend the tracks. To do that, select the layer and then move over to the effects control panel. Inside the opacity section of the effects control panel, we're going to select a blend mode. Click on the pull-down menu and then select darken. This will blend the darker midtones, shadows and blacks of the current track with the underlying tracks. Our main subject in the foreground is darker than the background, which contains a lot of highlights. So this will work perfectly in this scenario. Let's also select the same blend mode for the other two tracks. Select the track on the timeline, move over to the effects control panel and then select the darken for blend mode. Also the same option for the last track. As you can see right away, all the layers are now combined. And if I give it a playback, it will look like this. In case you have a clip with a darker background and a lighter subject in the foreground, you need to select Lighten for the blend mode. This will blend the lighter midtones and highlights with the underlying tracks, and you'll get the same results. That's it for this quick tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please like the video. That would help a lot. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you back soon for more. See you next time on